starting to get a profile as a master of the overtake, zipping past folks left, right, and center. I get it, man. Stay out of the way.
About a slight detour, you know, something a little extracurricular. I know the answer is yes, of course it is. What I like about you, you got hunger. So I got this concept for you. It's called a throwdown. Sounds cool? That's because it is cool. A throwdown is like a challenge, a one-off challenge. You see, us superstars like to keep each other on our toes, so we like to throw down a little skill check. And guess what? You've been tapped for one. Funny how this keeps happening. I say something, then it happens. I don't know, maybe I'm a wizard.
Okay, stop. What you're telling me is that Peter, aka Slaptrain, the dude with the nerves of steel, went from the YouTubes to the drift cars. This brave dude got freaking scared by a squirrel?
Come on, guys. I mean, I appreciate it all. It was an angry looking squirrel, though, James. I mean, you guys weren't there.
Yeah, they are scary.
Yeah,
sometimes
they, you know, they're rats with bushy tails. But time to get serious, all right? Let's bring it down. This is why you're on the show, all right? We gotta ask. What do you think of Bruno Durand?
Okay, I knew it was gonna come. Figured, right? Let's get serious about it.
Yeah, he's been beefing with everyone lately. He's ruffled some feathers out there, especially James's. But his driving on the track, like, it backs all that trash talk up. So, are you a fan?
Am I a fan of Bruno Durand? I mean, in a way, yes. It's hard not to be impressed by his run of victories.
Absolutely.
He said he'd do it too.
Yep.
Now he's dominated in the Dirt Moto series his whole career, and now he's showing he's mastered the four wheels too. I mean, what can't this guy do?
Yeah, I mean, I cannot help but be impressed. And to be honest, he had to do something. I mean, you watch him in the Dirt Moto series, just wasn't doing it for him anymore. He wasn't getting any joy, no satisfaction out of it. So what does he do? He throws a little baby fit, he yells at a couple reporters after a couple of races, and apparently that's all you need to get a top seat in the Dirt Off-Road Series these days.
I'm gonna go yell at some people.
Yeah, I'm gonna go yell at some people. Maybe I could be a race car driver.
I did see that it's dirty, it's gritty, but the gamble paid off. And yeah, I do enjoy the attitude. I don't really think it's entirely sincere,
ooh,
though.
Ooh, juicy! Yeah. Getting a little spicy in here.
So you're saying it's a bit of an act, then?
I mean, to a degree, he's already established in another motorsport, and now he's dominant in this series, too?
Yeah, I mean, one thing that this dude does not lack is confidence, so I'll give him that.
Right, so the race seems to be won before he rolls up to the starting line. He gets in your head, and he gets that mental edge over you before the race is even started. That's a strategy.
Yeah, one he's used his whole career before he switched over. And that counts for nothing if they don't back it out on the track.
Exactly, and he does, though. That's the problem. But be sure, we all want to know how he reacts to a loss. What is he going to do?
Yeah, exactly. You know, that is just as important to any champion, to any sportsman. You know, winning, you know, I don't want to say it's easy, but it's easy after you've won. What's really hard is after you've lost. So who do you see beating him?
I've thought of it a few times. It's a tough one, but I got one in mind, and I'm gonna give you another option that I'm not too sure on, but hey.
All right, cool, man. We're all ears. Hit us.
First, I'd say AJ.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
Why have we not seen them in the main event together yet?
Yeah,
why?
That's a good question, man.
I think there's something behind that, though. There has to be. I mean, if you think about it, there has to have been an opportunity somewhere down the line.
I know, you would think that, but then you look at all the main events, and it just never came. And here's the thing. When has our boy AJ ever backed down from a challenge?
Right? So there's AJ, and I think he actually wins that matchup, and maybe that's why we haven't seen it yet.
Yes!
I like that this has turned into a conspiracy podcast. Who else you got?
Okay, wait, before, maybe somebody emerges from the smaller teams.
Exactly. That's what I'm thinking. So we've seen this before. Someone just shows up, and they bring something a bit different, something fresh, something new we've never seen before.
Sauce.
Yeah, a little sauce. A little dry rub. You know, something spicy,
yeah.
Right?
Let
and whether that's a skill or a style or whatever. And I want to point out that is very much like what Durand has done. But this person, I don't necessarily think has to be established in another motorsport.
No, exactly. You got me thinking about some sauce, though. A little bit of honey barbecue goes a long way right now, right? But
yeah,
somebody up and coming, though. Someone up and coming, and there's one or two that might be on the rise right now. So keep an eye out on that talent.
So I gotta ask, how do you like your chances?
I've thought of it. I mean, to be honest, though, it's easy, right? No problem. I'm gonna leave it to them, though. I'm a bit busy at the moment to get involved.
All right, man. I like your style. Watch out for those squirrels before you get into any race cars. We gotta take care of some sponsorship stuff. We'll be right back. It's the Dirt Podcast by Donut Media.